Come on home. Cecelia.
This is the Cecelia Report, and I'm Cecelia, and I'm a vet student who likes to make videos. Today, we're going to be talking about the NAVLE. The NAVLE stands for the North American Veterinary Licensing Exam. It's a very big test that all fourth-year veterinary students have to take that determines whether they can be a licensed practicing veterinarian in the United States or Canada. I take mine in 3 days from the filming of this video. This exam is by all regards the most important test you'll take while you're in vet school. Like most other licensing exams for other professions, you can try again if you fail, but it'll cost you another like $700, plus you have to wait another 6 months with only further delays when you can get your actual license and start practicing medicine and start paying back loans, so it's pretty important that you actually pass. Well, what does this super important exam entail? Well, that's what I'm here for today. The NAVLE is 360 multiple choice questions that can pertain to literally any aspect of veterinary medicine. Although from my understanding, most of them are case management questions, which makes sense because that's what being a doctor is kind of about. Absolutely everything is fair game, from a sneezing dog to a toucan with liver disease. As veterinarians, we have to know how to diagnose and treat literally every single species that's not a human. But even then, we still have to know about zoonotic infections in humans. Of course, there are so many species of animals on the planet. In veterinary school, you focus on the big four. Cats, dogs, equine, and ruminants. So the NAVLE is divided into well-established percentage groups. So as you can see here, we know going into the test that most of the questions will be from the big four. As for the other questions that aren't covered in these percentages, well, it could be anything from honeybees to sea lions to prairie dogs and iguanas and even questions about business and epidemiology. The NAVLE takes place over about 6 hours and is scored out of 800 points. Now you might be thinking, well, that doesn't really make any sense because you said there was 360 questions on the test. Well, you'd be right about that. In fact, actually 60 of those 360 questions are being beta tested for the next year's NAVLE, so they're not actually scored. Unlike most tests that you may have taken at a testing center before, like for example a CLEP test, you do not get your score back immediately after you take the exam. Instead, after the exam taking window is over, which it's November to December if you do the fall window, all the exams and scores go to a team of veterinarians, and this team goes through each question individually and assigns them a point value based on difficulty and clarity. Then your exams are run through this new algorithm and that determines whether you pass or not. This makes the process kind of nerve-wracking because that means there's not a percentage of questions right you have to shoot for because that percentage is not established until well after you've taken your exam. This whole process takes quite a while, and while I'm taking my exam on November 2nd, I'm not going to find out if I pass until mid to late January. Studying for the NAVLE can be quite a beast. I mean, you literally have to cover everything. Since it can be very overwhelming to even know where to start, most people, myself included, choose to purchase a NAVLE preparation course. The two popular ones are Zuku Review and Vet Prep. They're both about the same thing and cost the exact same amount of money, so it doesn't really matter which one you get. I got Vet Prep and I have no good reason why I chose it over the other one. The preparation sites are great and I absolutely love my subscription. They both have different questions and answers to work through, and they give you explanations about why that certain answer was right. And they both have timed exam modes so you can get used to the rigors of having to answer 65 questions in 60 minutes. They also have other helpful tools like study sheets and videos. Generally, it's highly recommended to do additional studying outside of your Vet Prep and Zuku subscriptions. In fact, both of them give you statistics about what areas you need work in, which would really be helpful about like what areas you should focus on the most. As I mentioned in my previous vet school study video, studying does look different for everyone, but this is what I do. So I started studying for my NAVLE in May of this year. As I mentioned in previous videos, I've already been making these study guides the entire time I was in vet school in preparation for the NAVLE. They are my NAVLE notes. So I've been going through these notes and along the way I've been typing up thorough study guides. When I run into like a concept or a disease or something that I'm not super familiar with or don't quite remember as well as I should, then I turn to textbooks or consensus statements or frankly even the Merck Veterinary Manual to bring myself up to speed. After literal months of working on these study guides, I now have study guides written up for equine medicine, cardiology, ophthalmology, neurology, musculoskeletal diseases, parasitology, poultry medicine, swine medicine, theriogenology, and large animal toxic plants. Each of these vary from about 25 pages in length to 100-something pages in length. I would have definitely liked to have done more, but it's literally impossible to fit everything into just that few month time span. So I know I'm really strong in areas like pharmacology, endocrinology, and like literally anything to do with cats. So instead of like spending time on those that I already know I'm probably gonna do well in, I decided to focus my thoughts on things that I needed help in, like turkeys. In addition to the study guides, I've also been making some note cards along the way, just for the things that I just can't seem to get straight ever, like types of Salter Harris fractures and leptocerebrar maintenance hosts. You might be thinking, how long did this all take you? Well, I don't really know, but I do know that I started putting Grey's Anatomy on in the background while I've been studying because I think it's really good background noise, and I'm halfway through season 9.
What? No, I'm totally fine. Look. Totally fine.
Really, any study plan for the NAVLE is okay, as long as you make a plan based off of what you think you need help in, and then you stick to your plan. Studying for boards isn't all that bad, though. It's really great to know that every vet student in the country is going through the same thing as me. A few corporate brands and veterinary practices have been hosting these NAVLE trivia nights for us on Zoom, and they're super duper fun. I try to go to all the ones I can, and I even won $100 at one of them for getting one of the top scores. Also at my school, some of the professors have been hosting NAVLE review sessions, and it's really fun to be able to sit in the classroom again with your friends, take notes, after you've been in clinics all day. I also personally hosted a NAVLE Jeopardy party for my friends. It was really great review to write all the questions, and it was really fun to go through them and pretend to be Alex Trebek, and it was the most fun I've had in a while. Anyways, that's the end of the video. I hope you guys all learned something about the NAVLE today, and if you're a vet student or future vet student, maybe you gained something about what you want to do to study when it's your turn to take the NAVLE. Well, this is the Cecilia Report, and I'm Cecilia. Goodbye!
Savannah, I hope to be there by the morning and see this pine all transform.
So pick me. Choose me. Love me.